What's going on, guys? This is me, Mehdi Shakil here, and you are watching my YouTube channel, SSTec Tutorial. So guys, today in this video, I'm going to show you that how you can install Kali Linux 2020.2 on VMware workstation with the dual monitor setup. Yes, guys, I make lots of video about installing Kali Linux on VMware, but this is going to be my first video, which I'm gonna set up dual monitor with the VMware workstation using Kali Linux 2020.2. To make this setup, first you need to watch my previous video about using dual monitor setup without graphics card. If you don't have any graphics card, then you can watch my that video about how you can set up the dual monitor without having any graphics card. So guys, without talking too much, let's get started. Don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe my YouTube channel SSTec Tutorial and stay connected with my channel. Okay guys, so as I said that I'm gonna install Kali Linux 2020.2 on VMware. So we need to download VMware workstation and Kali Linux ISO image. You will find the VMware download link in description. And for the lifetime license key, go to my Instagram profile and DM me. Now let me show you which Kali Linux ISO you should download, because Kali Linux did lots of changes to their ISO files. So you have to download the right ISO to install Kali Linux on VMware. Now open up any of your favorite browser. Then go to kali.org, Kali Linux official website. Take the mouse pointer over download. Then from the drop down, click on Kali Linux download. Now in this download page, you will get different types of Kali Linux ISO. Download only between 32-bit or 64-bit installer ISO. Do not download other net installer or live ISO. I had already downloaded it. Now close your browser. Now open up VMware workstation. You will find the download link in description. And again guys, for the license key, follow me on my Instagram and DM me. Let me remove my old Kali Linux virtual machine from VMware. Okay, now click on create. Select install disk image. Click on browse and select the Kali Linux 2020.2 ISO file, whatever you downloaded before. Then hit next. Now from here, choose and select Linux and Debian 9x64-bit as we downloaded 64-bit ISO. Then hit next. And now here, give a name to your virtual machine, anything you want. I am typing here Kali Linux 2020.2. Now give here virtual disk size. For better performance, I am going to create 100 GB. Then select store single disk for better performance. Now hit next. Now click on customize, and from here you need to give RAM to your virtual Kali Linux machine depending on your RAM size. I have 8 gigs of RAM, so I am giving Kali Linux 2 gigs. And from here you can select processor cores for Kali or keep it as it is. Then close it. Now our configuration is done. Then just simply click on power on this virtual machine. And our installation will be started. Select graphical install from the drop-down menu. Then select your language, your location, your keyboard layout, Then it will detect your virtual disk and load the installer component from the ISO. Then it will configure your network for the internet connectivity. Keep the host name as it is, or you can change it. Then hit next. Now here, give a domain name, whatever you want. I am giving here kali.org. Now here you need to create a user account. Kali Linux doesn't support default root account anymore. So give a username here. Then hit next. Type a password for your account. Now here select the time zone. Then here you need to create a partition. You can do it automatically or manually. For this video I'll go with automatically. If you want to know how to partition disk manually for Kali Linux, you can watch my direct installation video. Finish the partitioning. Now here select yes to write changes on disk. Then it will create partition and it will configure the package manager. And this is the new thing on Kali Linux 2020.2. From here, you can select any of this desktop environment like XFCE, GNOME and others. Also from here, you can select which tool category you want to install. And it will start installation. You need to wait for some time. After some time, you will get group bootloader installation screen. Select master boot record from here. Then select /dev/sda and continue. Then just wait. It will finish the installation and reboot your Kali Linux virtual machine. Now our Kali Linux is installed successfully. Now log into your user account using your username and password, whatever you set during the installation. Now here you can see our Kali Linux is ready. Now let's go to my camera. And here you can see I have dual monitor. But Kali Linux virtual machine showing in one monitor. To extend Kali Linux VMware machine display to multiple monitor, you need to do one thing. Let me show you. Go to VMware view option and here you will get an option named Cycle Multiple Monitor. Click on Cycle Multiple Monitor. And it's done. Now let's change this monitor wallpaper. And now here you can see my Kali Linux virtual machine extended to dual monitor. And in this way you can take use of multiple screen using Kali Linux virtual machine. You will get lots of space for terminal and application on multiple monitors. So guys, that's all for today. I hope you like this video. If you really like this video and enjoy this video, then please give it a big thumbs up and share this video with a friend. And if you are new on my channel, then please do subscribe my YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to get all the latest upcoming video tutorial notification. I am Mehdi Shakil. You are watching SSTec tutorial and I'm signing out.